Bună dimineața și bun găsit la BIU. Sunt Sabina Iosub și vă invit să rămâneți alături de mine în următoarea jumătate de oră, căci o să discutăm despre bani. Multe fonduri europene pot fi accesate inclusiv de țara noastră. Vedem exact care este discuția, așadar, la nivel european. Today here with me in European Parliament in Strasbourg is Constanze Krell. Thank you so much for your presence.
Good morning.
I think it's important to see together what are the main debates regarding the cohesion policy and the regional policy and what money is put into this area.
Yeah, it's interesting that we finalized the whole issue in the last plenary in Brussels in the end of June. And now we can start from the beginning of the 1st of July this year in every country, every member state to use these money. We have fortunately around 330 billion euros for the whole European Union for the next 7 years. Plus the Just Transition Fund, plus the REACT-EU, and Romania will participate in all these programs, and I am very happy that we are now can start. If you work now on the operational programs in the regions, then you have to know that you can start already from the beginning of this year with projects already started. The priority is that you fulfilled all criteria, but I'm sure that Romania is very well prepared.
What type of criteria should we fulfill? And I'm also referring to any country that can access this type of funds. I don't know if your country will want to get some money from these funds.
Yes, this is the success of the Parliament because we insisted that every region can participate in the cohesion, European cohesion policy. I think that is necessary that nobody is left out. Of course, we have indicators, and depending from the indicators, you get more money or less money. And Romania is in the category for the less developed countries, and so you get much more money than, for example, Germany. And in Germany, we have the situation that in East Germany, we are more or less, every region is in a so-called transition region, and the rest is in a better developed region. That makes the difference earning the money from the cohesion fund. But I think it's really necessary that every citizen in the European Union can see that the European Union takes care about their problems and about the solutions.
When discussing about cohesion policy, regional policies in general, we see which type of development. What can we actually do in those areas that need some money, need some pushes in order to develop? Can see the social development or the developments in infrastructure. What do you consider should be first put in this area?
I think Romania is a country which can use the money for, in principle, for all priorities, for infrastructure, for supporting enterprises, supporting universities, science labs, and so. But on the other side, of course, the social dimension is very important to fight against unemployment, to fight against poverty. It is really necessary. And so we have on the one side the European Regional Fund and the European Cohesion Fund. And on the other side, we have the European Social Fund. And I say every time, the one thing is the hardware, the other thing is the software. And you know, a computer can only work with both of them. And so it's the same for the cohesion policy. You need both sides, the economic development and the social development. What is important, and this is new, that we should follow the ideas of the Green Deal for the development in the countries. We have to use 30% of the funds for fulfilling the criteria of the Green Deal, and this is really a big pocket of money to fulfill the criteria of the climate neutrality for 2050.
If we take the example of your country, of Germany, in which regions do you consider that you can use most of this money?
As I said already, in East Germany we were using from the beginning mm-hmm. on a lot of money from the European regional policy, and we really can see a success. We started in principle like Romania 30 years ago, maybe Romania a little bit later because they became member of the EU only 2007. But in East Germany, we really can see that it was a great development. I personally come from Leipzig. We started with zero. We had a very big brown coal area in the south of Leipzig. We had to send in unemployment from one day to another in the 1991 55,000 people. And you can imagine, and you see the same situation probably in Romania sometimes. This was really a very difficult situation. And now Leipzig is one of the better developed regions already, the only one in East Germany. But it shows that it's really helpful to have this European support, because without the European support, we could not reach this situation now.
You've been several times to Romania. Yes. You know most of the country. I know that you've seen a lot of improvements made during time. If you are here, let's say, to give us an advice, what should we focus on?
Yeah, I think you started really to work hard on scientists, research, development of new technologies in cooperation with big enterprises in Europe. And I think this is a recipe which can be very helpful. On the other side, you have, of course, to develop the infrastructure, what you are doing. I don't know if you plan now to have this more green or more sustainable. This is the next step. I hope you will do this, or not you personally, but yes. Romania, because this is the way to match the sustainable economic development on the one side, and to fulfill after some years also the criteria and the targets for the climate neutrality.
In your opinion, how difficult was this pandemic period for all the member states?
It was very difficult, I think, for every member state. And especially in the relationship to the European funds, it was very difficult because you had to close from one day to another a lot of projects, but you had to pay for this and to find a possibility to make a management which can postpone all the things a little bit. This was difficult, but on the other side, you have to fight against the pandemic itself. It was learning and doing in the same time. I'm quite sure after 10 years we will see that we made mistakes and what we can do in a better way. And the best thing what we should learn is that we have to react as a union. It makes no sense to close borders. It makes no sense to say, oh, you have to do this or you have to do this. We have to do this all together, because a virus will cross every border. If the border is closed or not, it doesn't care the virus. And so we have to find ways how we can react to get all together. Because we saw how difficult it is if you close the borders, then the delivery of products and so it is really difficult and the people can't move. It is not the way we should live in the future.
What is the situation now in your country, in Germany, point of view? Yeah,
with the pandemic. Oh, in the moment, it's really good. We have incidence from below 5. In Leipzig, 2.4. That's really good. But we have to take care, because I'm a little bit afraid that we have now in Germany the vaccination first time 58%, I think. And the second time, 36%. This is not enough, and we have to ask that the people, even now in a very better situation, should go to the vaccination, because I'm afraid that the virus not stopped yet and will come back maybe in autumn a little bit stronger than today, and so we have to be prepared. And I can only say vaccination is a good issue, and it's helping yourself, but it helps also other people. And I think that is the best way to fight against the virus.
Did the politicians understand anything from this period, learn something?
I hope so. Look, when we are looking into the European Parliament, we learned a lot about better digitalization and digital communication. And I saw, for example, in Germany, how difficult it is to have homeschooling on a digital basis and in family with two or three children. Then you need really a very good internet and you need for everybody a tablet or a PC. And this is not easy, and the schools were not prepared in Germany, and I hope that we learn now what we have to do in the next future to support especially the children and the kids, that they can learn a little bit even in a pandemic. I hope that we learned enough in the parliament to prepare ourselves for the next situation, and I hope that in every member state we learn the lessons.
This development of education might go under the may go under the umbrella of regional development in order to increase the situation in some specific regions.
Yes, of course, you can use the European Regional Fund for a better digital communication, but also the programs from the Next Generation EU, this 750 billions where the member state got the possibility to use this money. And this is under the headline Green Deal on the one side, digitalization on the other side.
It's important to see the mix, right?
Yes.
The mix of funds and understand how to use them, to combine them in order to have a bigger success, let's say.
Yes, you're completely right. We made it more flexible that you can switch between the funds, switch between the categories. You can combine the regional funds with the research program or environmental programs. Yes, this is possible, and we hope that we made it more simple than the last time.
Thank you so much, Constanze Krell, for explaining to us the whole discussion that was made here at the European level regarding the regional funds, regarding the cohesion policy. Your advices are good for us. Thank you again.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Iar vouă celor de acasă vă spun să rămâneți alături de mine în continuare pe Antena 3. Iată despre ce mai discutăm.